Stoffe Viker, Viktor Pettersson, Johan Svan. Stoffe Viker, Viktor Pettersson and Johan Svan. Behind the computer over there, we have also Theo and Simon. What you see here is, of course, a VR setup. This is pretty interesting because this is a case we've been working on for quite some while. Because what we have discussed is, you know, where is the real experience of food? Is it on your tongue? Is it in your brain? Where is it? And can we change that with the help of digital methods? So we set up a project trying to test what food can be in the digital realms. Can we bring new ways of creating food and food experiences to the world with the help of tech? So I need a volunteer now in the audience. Do we have anyone? There is? Oh, yes, lovely. Come up on stage. Let's have a kiss.
Det är svart där. Det är svart i där. So, let's see.
So, put, no, you won't see this until you've put it on the...
Sorry. Digital problems, of course. Always digital problems. Yeah. Keep it hidden.
Yes, I'll keep it hidden. It's a secret.
Fortfarande. Okay. Okej, okay, så då rycker vi den här då. Ah, crap. Nu då. Svart. Ah, oh, sorry. Let's see. Where is this?
Almost there.
Almost there. This is
thanks
this
for
is,
the patience.
Thanks for the patience. It's always fun with the digital experiences here, and we're testing something that we haven't that we actually finished this morning.
It's very crazy deadline.
It's a very crazy deadline we put to ourselves to show. No, Tess, you must not lift the lid on that.
Okay, sorry.
You must not.
Big secret.
Let's see. No, everything just died. Of course, this is how it does.
Okay.
Should we?
No, but let's talk a little bit about VR and AR instead here around this. So perhaps while we're testing the equipment and making sure that it works properly, we can perhaps start with the handing the clicker to you, Johan, because right. Johan here is an expert on how do you call it sensory
science and sensory marketing and
yes.
How we experience food yeah. And how our brain works in relation to taste, basically.
Exactly.
So, yeah.
Wonderful. So you've been working with Haston Blumenthal and a bunch of the top chefs out there, and currently you're doing a fantastic job at Grythyttan, so one of our leading experts on sensory system. So, and Victor here, of course, is one of the leading experts we have in Sweden on VR and virtual reality and augmented reality then. And runs a center that's kind of a fascinating place to hang out when we're...
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, where's that?
It's at Söder, Folkungagatan 44, called Mission IX.
So if you Mission IX.
Virtual reality.
Yeah, and you can go there actually to experience VR in real life,
yeah.
Right? So, but to you, Johan.
Should I start?
Start.
All right.
Tell
All right,
us,
cool.
How do we perceive and eat food?
Yeah, I thought it would be like a good idea to actually talk about how we experience food and what sensory experience is. And we're going to talk about how we perceive food and how we're going to eat food in the future, but also from a scientific part, how we experience food. And this presentation was supposed to be after this, but I think this is a really good education for you guys to see how we perceive food. This is basically food for me. This is a plate with a fork and a knife, and this is a dish. This is how you experience food. This is taste. And now, of course, you wonder, what the hell do I mean about that? But the thing is, on this plate, you can have meat, vegetables, potatoes, whatever it is. But in the center of the plate, you see two cubes. The cube above is dark gray, and the cube below is light gray. That's true, isn't it? It's quite easy. And it's just your sight telling you that. But the thing is these two cubes have the same color intensity. So basically, they have the same taste. It's just the context of the plate and the food and how you present it and telling you how to experience it. So if I just cover a bit of the plate and just do it like that, you will see they have the same color intensity. And this is how the brain works, quite simply. And if you look at perception and reality, you can look at this. This is vanilla. So if you see vanilla like this, or you hear the word vanilla, your brain automatically is telling you it's going to be sweet, it tastes like cookies, or you get like associations to cookies or yogurt or whatever it is. It's just your brain. It's going on autopilot and telling you this is what you're going to perceive. But if you ever tried to taste vanilla, it doesn't have any sweetness to it at all. It's just bitter and really disgusting, basically. So, and the same thing here, you can play with yourself, you can have a strawberry mousse, and you can plate that on a black plate or on a white plate. And if you serve it like this, you're gonna have a significantly much better taste on a white plate. It's gonna be tastier, it's gonna have a better strawberry feeling and better strawberry flavor than serving it on a black plate. So basically, what it's all about is the brain. And what I've been talking about and what we're gonna do here later is just to play around with sensation and perception. Because if you just have sensation, it's just what we talked about earlier here today when he talked about coffee and whiskey. It's like having coffee for the first time and you just drink it, but you have no idea what it is. You have never seen coffee before. You're gonna feel, you know, you're gonna experience it quite bitter and it's gonna be quite disgusting. But you need a perception of it. You need to have like understand the sensory information. So what we're gonna play around with here is play with sight, hearing, touch, smell, and taste, and put that in relation to perception, like when it comes to memories, knowledge, experience, and that's where you can create a food experience and taste. And that's why I think this is so interesting to work with these people when it comes to science and sensory science and technology in order to create the future of food, but also that we can eat better, tastier food in the future, but also maybe more sustainable. And I know we see a lot of trends out there and a lot of companies playing around with this, which I think is just amazing. So for me, this is just like a candy shop being around with you guys and you know, trying to measure how we feel and experience things.
Mm. No, it's truly amazing. Now, we're wondering here, it seems like we have some sort of a system up and running. Do you see something in your... So
we take my slide as well.
Yeah,
then.
Let's take your slides as well while we do the setup. So,
all right, and this was really a new world for me as well, meeting this team and the passion with both of you. And my passion is from the technology side when it comes to virtual reality, augmented reality, and where we see different trends, several interesting trends within this field of technology, but some of them is on this screen here. We have virtual reality as it was prior, it was a really isolated and solitary experiences with just one people in one world and a virtual world for that. But now we see different platforms where you can actually meet your friend, your virtual friends out there, not only on Facebook, but for real with their avatars, or pretty soon also, if they want to, with their own selves, 3D scans themselves. And we also have the first experience of virtual reality, really visual and also audio, but we now see also experiments with multisensory feedback. So haptic feedback, for example, is very interesting too. This picture you see here comes from Steven Spielberg's latest movie, Ready Player One. Have anybody seen that one? Okay, 2, 3, 10, okay, great. It's an interesting movie of what the future might look like. And this haptic vest he's wearing can feel touch. So if somebody touch you in the virtual world, you can feel it. And then we also see the virtual world becoming more visible in the real world. So you have augmented reality where you place virtual objects within the real world, which you almost can touch, but not really. Or you place virtual real objects in a virtual world, which we are doing here. And you have different trends as well here when it comes to other technologies and stuff like that, but all these merge out in very interesting applications for the future. And I see the restaurant industry will be revolutionized with so much interesting scalable concept where you both can have environmental friendly solutions for exchanging meat for something else, or you can have scalable concepts where you go to the restaurant and you have, instead of a menu, you have your iPad and you can actually see the food you want to eat, because like you said, it's really visual, yeah, if you want to eat it or not. And all these very interesting business ideas and impact on the society.
So chefs in the future, they will have like not just you know, someone working next to you to cut all the onions, but someone doing the programming as well, because everyone will have a window table.
Of course.
And see the chef's table. Yeah.
I mean, you can meet your virtual friend on a perfectly nice beach on Bali, and still eat together for real.
For real, and have the same tastes of things as well, right?
Or whatever taste you like.
Or what taste you like.
Maybe
like
you have a company delivering to your home the perfect VR on the beach dinner, and it's both a program and
exactly. But doesn't this mean that in the future, recipe or dish will come with, well, the food, of course, itself, but also perhaps with the packaging around it, giving you that sensory experience. And it's not in the food anymore; it's in
the brain.
In the brain, right? And that's being augmented with the help of digital.
Yeah.
So everyone can have like corn porridge and think it's like truffle risotto or whatever it is.
Can imagine having like a really nice greasy pizza slice with like 300 calories. But that is just your brain telling you that's what you're eating. But in the real life, you're eating like a really healthy pizza with the same like sensory attributes. But your brain is telling you something else. But you can eat a pizza and be healthy. That would be like a
That would be perfect, you know, heaven.
Yeah, that would be heaven. Yeah, of course.
No, but isn't this also about democracy, right? Because suddenly, you know, since digital is cheap, it's free, right? Or you know, it's not as expensive to produce as Russian caviar or beef, right? Yeah. So then, but you can give everyone those types of experiences around food that you can only have at the finest restaurants, right?
That's true. Yeah.
So suddenly, yeah, the best food in the world is accessible for everyone.
Yeah.
And I mean, you have new food. But you have the same food, but with totally different imaginations. I mean, the space food out there would probably taste much better in space.
Yeah.
Or what's the next best torsk fillet taste out there? Maybe something totally different.
Yeah.
And more environmental friendly as well.
Yeah, most probably. Yeah.
Because you mentioned here white plates and black plates, for instance. Mm-hmm. And you're doing currently an experiment down in Kungsträdgården, Sense Lab.
Yeah, we're doing that. We took the research lab and moved that from the university, and we have a research lab now in FoodTech Village at Smakapa Stockholm. And we are currently doing two really large experiments when it comes to taste and music. So we've been creating music that will enhance different kinds of basic tastes. So together with the chocolate fabric here in Sweden, we've been creating different kinds of chocolates. But at the same time you're eating this chocolate, you will listen to different kinds of music, because the music could or could not enhance different kinds of flavors. So what we're trying to do here in this project is to see how can music help us in the future to eat better and healthier food. So, for example, in the school environment, when you go to like, you know, high school or whatever it is, can you imagine playing music in order to make the kids in the school to perceive better sweetness or saltiness in the food, but in the real life, you actually, you know, decrease the saltiness and sweetness in the food. But just to play the right music, your brain is telling you have a sweeter experience. So that's what we're trying to do now. So yeah, we've been doing, it's really big. I thought we were supposed to have like 100 consumers come to this Sense Lab a day. We've been having over 300 people almost coming to this lab every day. So we had to, you know, make it a bit bigger. But
okay, so that's wonderful. But you can really trick the brain quite a lot with these types of techniques, you know, red. Well, is it red that makes things taste sweeter?
Yeah, if you look at people when they like have to match different kinds of colors to different kinds of basic tastes. Always like white is like salty, then you have the green is always bitter, the red is always sweeter, for example. And you can take that kind of a theory back to when you're creating like food packaging or, you know, making communications in order to enhance the flavors of the product. And but the flavor is not there, of course, it's just the color is telling your brain, it's like, oh, it's going to be sweeter, but it's not sweeter, because you can't trust your senses in that way.
This is really interesting. How are we doing now?
I have no idea what things are. Okay, it's working.
So okay. Let's go over now to the test. Stoffe, what are we going to do now? Please tell us.
Oh, hi, fantastic. Technology. So,
big hand for the tech.
So what we've tried to do with Johan and Johan and Victor here was that we tried to build a VR system so that we could see if we could experiment with how the brain perceived taste. So what we did was that we made some food, VR food that is. So what you can do right now is that if you look down, and let's see now.
You talk to me.
Yes, yeah. I'm looking, talking to you, sorry. And as you see here right now, there's a spoon, not a spoon, but a fork. If you take that, you should be able to control that now. And on it is actually real food. Yes, so if, let's see now, if it is it tracking? Yes, you should be able to look at that. Yes, there you go.
You see it?
Yes, and now you can actually taste that if you want. If you want.
Ah, there it is.
Yes.
So the audience can.
Yes, the audience can see everything that you see as well.
Yes, it looks like tofu or something.
Yeah.
For me?
Yeah, it's supposed to be chicken. Sorry.
I'm vegetarian, but okay.
Okay, yes. This is okay for you. Promise. Yes, there you go.
Is it chicken?
No. Well, no, it's.
Well, you know, who knows?
You're okay. You're okay.
Yeah.
Yep. Yes.
How does it taste?
How does it taste? That's the important thing.
If I'm going to be honest, it tastes like tofu.
Taste? Yeah, but it is a test.
It is a test.
It is a test.
It's cheating to have a vegetarian doing this test.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it could be chicken.
It could be chicken?
Yeah.
Okay. But that was what we aimed for. We wanted to make it so that what you see in your what you see in your VR headset will help your brain perceive it as maybe something else. And if you hold up your fork and we switch a little bit, so what we can do is that we can actually, let's see now, yep, we can do some switching around and we can actually do it so that it's meat or if it's salmon or if it's chicken, and we can do all these things because we can change the texture of the food in the VR headset. So what we're planning for going forward from here is that we should make more different kinds of shapes and forms and textures for the meat that it is. And then you can eat whatever you want, or if you want to eat tofu, but what the brain perceives is something else.
And you can also change the environment.
Oh, yes.
You want to dine somewhere else or add your friends.
Yes. Here, only the imagination and a little bit of time sets the boundaries of what you can do. But what if you want to have a nice dinner with your fiance or wife or whatever on a beach in the sunset or during day, you can do that as well, as long as you can get that VR stage set up for you. And then in the future, we are looking to do liquids as well, but that's much harder right now.
No, thank you so much. And so this is just the first experiment. We wanted to come here and show it to you. And our ambition is to improve on this and build the new shapes and eventually to invite you all to a dinner experience in the virtual world. I hope you will join me. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Tack så mycket.
So